In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform an internal podalic version during the delivery of the second twin. Internal podalic version is an obstetric procedure wherein the position of the fetus is turned around so one or both feet present through the cervix. Remember, internal podalic version only performed on the second baby after the delivery of the first baby of a twin pregnant mother. And don't forget, there is no place for an internal podalic version in a singleton pregnancy. The most common indication to perform the procedure is transverse or another abnormal position. Other common indications are fetal bradycardia, cord prolapse, and placenta abruptio, or conditions when you have to deliver the second baby promptly. Internal podalic version can be quicker, safer, and more reliable procedure than an emergency cesarean section if the operator is skilled and experienced. If you feel unsure, go for the cesarean section. Don't take any risk. But in a benign indication, it is recommended that you try the procedure first before converting to a cesarean section. There is no absolute contraindication to the procedure. You may perform the procedure in the labor room or in the operation theater with the preparation for an emergency cesarean section. The amniotic sac does not need to be intact. It's okay if the membrane ruptures during the procedure. If there is cervix spasm, you should use nitroglycerin. You may perform the procedure under general anesthesia, but analgesia by nitrous oxide gas inhalation in the labor room also works great. The technique I'm going to show you in this video for the internal podalic version takes less than 1 minute, usually between 20 to 30 seconds. So it is recommended that you try this procedure in the labor room when you have a short time to deliver the baby. The technique I'm going to demonstrate to you is not a conventional method. I have learned this technique from Dr. Marie Blomberg, a renowned professor of Linköping University, Sweden. I'm going to demonstrate this technique in a more difficult situation where the baby presents with a hand prolapse. In this situation, the internal podalic version can be quite difficult to perform with the conventional technique. Actually, I faced this situation where I performed the procedure for the first time in my life in reality and was successful in less than 30 seconds. Before starting the procedure, the first thing you should know is the position of the fetal head and back. Our objective is to grab the heels or the ankles of the fetus, but it's not always easy to reach them in the mother's uterus. In this special technique, the strategy will be pushing the fetal head high up to the fundus so that the buttock of the breech automatically comes to the cervical end within the uterus. Then follow the thighs, legs, and then you very easily reach to the fetal ankles. You may try to locate the position of the fetal head and back by external palpation or by ultrasonogram. If the fetal head and back lies on the left side, you should use your left hand. If the fetal head and back lies on the right side, use your right hand. If the fetal head lies anteriorly or posteriorly or unknown position, use your dominant hand. Now, we start the procedure. It is better to use long sterile gloves that cover your forearms. Lubricate your hand, put your hand into the vagina, and then go into the uterus. Find the back of the fetus and move to the fetal head. Grab the neck of the fetus and push the fetal high up, and high up to the fundus of the uterus. At this point, your whole forearm should be in the vagina. Now move your hand in the uterus to the cervix along the back of the fetus. When your hand reaches the level of the groins of the fetus, extend the fetal hip joints by drawing the both fetal thighs. Next, just follow the both fetal legs, and finally you will be able to grasp the both ankles of the fetus. Now you are done. Take the fetal feet out of the vagina and pull out the baby just like a breech delivery. It is so easy. I have done this procedure a couple of times in my professional life without any complication. Hope you like this video. If you have any questions, write in the comments below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done this yet. Thank you very much.